I'm with the Homestead Daddy. Homestead, it comes from your farm, George, and you have a mod. Bye.
He does such a better job than me.
Oh, apple's dropping.
Anyways, guys, I think what he said was that he's Danny from Swedish Homestead, that he just came from church, and that he has animals. Okay, anyway. So, yesterday we spread some hay bale over the pasture where the cows are eating to increase fertility. If you haven't checked out that video, just check out yesterday's video. Today, we're gonna do the other method that we are primarily using to increase fertility that I mentioned yesterday, which is the cattle's manure during the winter time. We capture it in a deep bedding, which is the nitrogen-rich cow manure and urine is being caught in a carbon-rich material, say straw or wood chips or wood shavings, whatever we can get our hands on. And then in the spring we compost that with our pigs. And so now I'm going to drive some of that stuff out on the fields and increase the fertility like that. So I'm here under the cow shelter that we built last year for the cattle to be under. This is the cow manure, or was the cow manure. It's the compost now. Look at this beautiful, gorgeous stuff that we have produced here. These guys have produced by digging through. Plan is to load this with a tractor on the quad trailer over there and drive it on the field, spread it out by hand. I'm not going to do too much. It would not be worth it to do a huge area by hand, but eventually we want to get a little manure spreader that you can actually pull behind an ATV. 2.5 cubic meters of manure usually go on there. And this stuff is super light. Light and fluffy compost. So it's really nice stuff. Bunch of this will still go on the garden, but we're going to start driving some of it on the fields. Now, I will have to change some stuff around here in the cow shelter this year for the cattle. We'll have two different sections. And we had a corner where the tractor is standing now. That part was where we were feeding, and we're going to change that now. So we're going to be feeding all along this wall. Up there is hay. Going to be just throwing the hay straight down to where the cows are, and then we can access that area here as well. So going to change a lot of things, but before we even do all of that, this area here is going to be where we will butcher and process 200 broilers the next 2 weekends. So 100 broilers this Saturday, and then 100 broilers the weekend after. So once the compost is out of here, that's what we're going to get ready and build here as well. First, I'm actually going to remove this pillar here because it's just in the way and it's not going to be here anyway. Then let's get going. Ugh. Not that you guys have any wrong idea about this, what I just took out of the ground, it didn't have any weight to carry. It was just there to have something to screw the feeder against.
Hey,
there's still a lot of cubic meters of compost here. It's a high value and I'm very thankful for it. So this is it. This is the quad trailer that has three buckets from the tractor full in there. And we're gonna take that now to the field. And this tool here, I'm not 100% sure what it is. I think it's from harvesting potatoes. But we're gonna use that to spread it.
Oh yeah, good boy.
We're gonna get more in a little bit. So this is one of our hay fields. And I am planning on spreading this over the hay field. Encouraging earthworms to come and giving fertility to this. If you have land that's just pasture, essentially the cattle are putting back most of the material. Here we're taking off grass, so we have to put something back.
I want to use my hand.
Yeah, careful with your hands so I don't hurt you with my tool here. Okay, put your hands away. Compost is known to be the best fertilizer that we know on this planet. Us doing this, it layers organic matter on top. And this way, we actually encourage the growth of fungi, we encourage the growth of the root system. It gets fluffier because of the earthworms, and it's a beautiful system. And we do not till, we do not disturb, which encourages this web in the soil that taps into the forest and everything to grow and not be disturbed. We need to store more carbon, more organic matter in the soil, both so we can absorb and hold more water, and to get higher yields. That is actually the biggest and number one hindrance for bigger yields is too little organic matter in the soil. So first trailer load is spread out. Gonna be doing this with a few more. One thing that I want to just say to clear out some possible misunderstandings. This carbon that we are putting back on this pasture now comes from forage and wood chips, the cow manure and wood chips, but that is not the most long-lasting carbon. This carbon will fairly quickly be put back into the atmosphere because it's going to be breaking down very quickly. The carbon that's more long-lasting is being created mainly by the root system, and that's why it's so important not to overgraze your pastures so that the grass can grow bigger, stronger, taller, and thereby also the root system grow deeper, stronger. And that is the die bag in the winter that will be the carbon that will last longer in the soil. Obviously, by putting this on top, this stimulates all the earthworms and the growth, the fertility, which produces more carbon on top in form of the plant above ground, and then more carbon in the ground in form of the root system. And that's what we're shooting for here. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I've got a lot of work to do, so I'm gonna get to it and put the camera aside. But hope you enjoyed that. Make sure to subscribe if you wanna follow our journey here on the homestead, and hope to see you soon in the next videos. Bye guys. Danny, wanna say bye?
Bye.
No, look at the camera, buddy. Bye.